Literary translation, part 3. Retention of syntactic patterns. In literary works, like we said last time, authors may make the language deviate from normal language use, and some grammatical structures may appear deviated. Today, we'll consider some grammatical strategies that translators use in solving the problems of syntactic non-equivalence, sentence length, tenses, appositive constructions. In the beginning, let's look at the translation of the following book title, نعم حواء تستطيع. The original title reads, Yes, she can. The English pronoun she, which exclusively refers to women, in this title can refer to either a man or a woman if translated as نعم تستطيع. If attached to the verb as a prefix, it could mean yes you can. Compare the following structures. نعم هي تستطيع. نعم تستطيع. نعم حواء تستطيع. The feminine pronoun in the first example can be dropped because the following verb starts with a pronominal suffix. Dropping the pronoun may make the sentence ambiguous because the pronominal suffix in example 2 will be regarded referring to the second person, addressing either man or woman. Therefore, the word حواء, Eve, was skillfully added to the title to replace the feminine pronoun. Maintaining the sentence length. Literary translation usually consists of longer and complicated sentences to maintain the flow of descriptions and ideas. Literary sentences may extend to a few lines. Let's consider the following example from The Great Gatsby. One sentence extends for 70 words, and you can easily find longer sentences in literature than in any other domain. Now, look at this example quoted from one of Maalouf's novels, Amin Maalouf. You can notice in this example how short sentences are. This could make the translator follow the same pattern. In a corpus-based study, Baker investigated the sentence length in literary translation. She used the fiction subcorpus from TEK, the translated English text, designed by her to examine the style of the literary translator. She found out that the average sentence length in the Arabic translated novels is much lower than the translated text from other languages. In this figure, you can notice that the novels translated from Arabic contain the shortest sentences. Baker noted that translators try to mediate the Arabic text by making them, in a sense, less challenging linguistically. Perhaps they subconsciously realize that the English reader faces sufficient challenges at the level of digesting the details of a very different world with different values, priorities, and a style of life. So, we can conclude that the translator from Arabic into English should pay attention to the sentence length in the target language. He can merge sentences to form longer sentences, as in the following example. You can notice that the first translated version contains short sentences, while the second merged sentences together to make it closer to the English literary style. Thank you.